As David Bollier said, billions of people around the world are right now thinking like commoners. I had a chance to talk with two of them this spring when I attended a meeting convened by the Transnational Institute and the Alternative Information and Development Center based in Cape Town, South Africa. Grasa Samu is the director of the Global March of Women, and Mayo Fuster is on the faculty of the Berkman Center for Internet and Society at Harvard University and a researcher at the Autonomous University of Barcelona.
Most of the women that I engage with, they are involved in agriculture and they organize their lives from their relationship with nature, the possibility of them to produce the food they want to eat, and to produce the other means of living which they need. So the debate that we are having here in common, it relates a lot with my background, where I come from, because it actually, we live in a reality where we don't have the state to take care of ourselves. We don't have the state institutions to deliver what we want, what we need. And it's the people, it's the women particularly, who organize the community life.
I discovered the commons through the internet and how far through the new technologies we can collaborate in order to create knowledge commons that democratize the access to knowledge. But then I jump into the urban commons, because I think the technology is also shaping the conditions of possibility of both the enclosement of the commons or actually the rising of the commons in the at the city level.
When we talk about production, is that okay, I can produce what I need, but it's not enough, because I don't, even if I say that I can produce vegetables, I can produce cassava, I can produce potatoes, there are things which I may not produce, so there are other women who will be producing other things. Women do it in rural areas in a communal way. It's not that they buy the labor of each other, but they support each other, because while they worked this week in this land, and next week they can be working in somebody else's land, but it's an exchange.
The natural commons and the, let's say, digital commons. For me, the core elements of both cases, or any typology of commons, is on the one hand, there are, as Grasa has said, on the one hand, there is a community of people self-organized mm-hmm. in order to collaboratively produce a resource. Mm-hmm. And they govern the process, and they collectively own the process. This is the first characteristic that is based on principle of the commons.
It's very much important to look at What do we understand as development? I think everything starts from there, because we fail to think what can be common, because we fail to define development on the right way. We use a concept of development, which is a Western concept, which is designed in thinking what is the standard that the world wants, not really what relates to the people who are involved in the process.
Somehow it assumes that there are some countries that are underdeveloped and that they need to reproduce a center model of development in order to develop. And the commons actually bring a totally different picture, because the commons, who actually were a pre-capitalistic form, are much more developed in the South, global South. So there is a lot of elements in which we can bring and learn from the so-called underdevelopment countries, and this is a channel in order to actually recover and survive in the development world. The commons provide a way in which to create interconnections between three main problems in the current development system. The first one is the excessive productiveness and exploitation of people conditions, and so a more collaborative and more human relations around creating and working together. The second one, it has to do with putting life and environmental in the center, a model much more environmentally friendly and recognition of nature, and also putting life in the center, referring to putting the needs of people in the center, not the profit. And in this way, we would solve the social dimension, the environmental dimension, and the gender and exclusion diversity dimension through the framework of the commons. It's what is a key that interconnect the three of them.
Even when we talk about the cities, or for instance, the rural areas or the villages, even in that same context, we still have inequalities, and we need to acknowledge these inequalities. If you live in the city, it doesn't mean that you are living all in the same standards. You are living and benefiting from a life of commonalities. We are living different levels, different standards, lots of exploitation. And in this, I want always to highlight the fact that there is too much invisibility of women's contribution, women's participation, and women's care work, which is very important to bring into the center of all the debate. And this relates to the nature, relates to these commons as a whole. Well.